Ready? Start. The present appeal has been preferred by the accused appellant against whom a criminal case bearing number RC 04/16 came to be registered along with four other accused persons for the offences punishable under sections 120B, 109, 150, 153A, 302, 201, read with section 34 of IBC, sections 3 and 27 of the Arms Act and sections 15, 16, 17, 18 and 20 of the Unlawful Activities within Bracket Prevention Act 1971. Bracket open. Hereinafter being referred to as UPA Act. Bracket close, full stop. After completion of the investigation, comma, final report was submitted before the trial court against the accused persons, including appellant, full stop. The appellant claims that there was no material for registering the criminal case, neither investigating nor submitting the final report against him, full stop, para. At this stage, comma, the appellant filed application under section 227 of Code of Criminal Procedure, comma, 1973, bracket open, hereinafter referred to as Cr.P.C, bracket close, seeking his discharge from the case for the aforesaid offences, full stop. The application was dismissed by the trial judge/special judge who ordered for framing of charges against him for the aforesaid offences under order dated 2nd January 2018 came to be challenged by the appellant in a writ petition filed under Article 226 and 227 of Constitution of India, read with Section 482 CRPC, which was dismissed by a lucid impugned judgment dated 22nd November 2018, which is a subject matter of challenge in the instant appeal, full stop, para. The background facts giving rise to this appeal, which needs to be noted, are that a criminal case came to be registered as crime number 124/2016 on 16th October 2016 for the offences punishable under section 302, read with section 34 IPC, by Commercial Street Police after a complaint was filed by one Jair Ram within bracket CW1, comma, who stated that on 16th October 2016 at around 12:40 p.m. when he along with his friends, namely Rudresh, Hari Krishna and Kumar, assembled near Srinivas Medical Stores, Shivaji Nagar, one person within bracket accused being the pillion rider of the motorcycle, had Rudresh with a sharp edged and lethal machete on the right side of his neck and fled. Rudresh was taken to a hospital wherein he was declared brought dead. Full stop, para. Initial four accused person, bracket open, accused numbers 1 to 4, bracket close, were arrested on 27th October 2016. Full stop. Accused number 5, within bracket appellant herein, was arrested on 2nd November 2016, full stop. Subsequently, comma, the task of investigation was entrusted to National Investigating Agency within bracket NIA by the Union of India, Ministry of Home Affairs, New Delhi on 7th December 2016, full stop. NIA registered FIR in RC number 24/2016 against all five accused persons, including the appellant, full stop. After investigation, the charge sheet was submitted against all five accused persons on 21st April, 2017, which stated that accused numbers 1 to 4 conspired with the accused appellant, within bracket accused number 5, to kill RSS members, and in furtherance of their acts, they committed offence punishable under sections 302, 201, read with section 34 IPC, full stop para. The accused persons were said to be in possession of weapons without license. Thereby, it attracted the offence punishable under sections 3 and 27 of the Arms Act, full stop. Further, the acts of the accused persons, including the accused appellant, amounted to offences punishable under sections 120B, 109, 150, 153A, 302, 201, read with section 34 IPC, and under sections 16, subsection 1A, 18 and 20 of the UPA Act, full stop para. The appellant sought discharge under section 227 Cr.P.C. along with other accused persons, which came to be rejected. Wide order dated 2nd January 2018 and framed charges against the accused persons, including accused appellant, full stop. A special NIA court under its order dated 2nd January 2018, while deciding the application of appellant seeking discharge under section 227 CRPC, observed that it was admitted by the defense counsel that the appellant is the president of Bengaluru unit of Popular Front of India, within bracket PFI, and the other accused persons numbers 1 to 4 are also the members of PFI, full stop para. It was also admitted by the defense counsel that there was frequent telephonic / mobile phone conversation among the accused persons numbers 1 to 5 prior and subsequent to 16th October 2016, bracket open, the date of the incident, bracket close, which gave raised to the special NIA code to arrive at a conclusion that the material placed in the charge sheet on record gives rise to sufficient grounds of subjective satisfaction of prima facie case of alleged offence of conspiracy being hatched among the accused persons, full stop. It further observed that the accused appellant has failed to justify the necessary ingredients of section 227 CRPC, and finally held that the matter deserved to be proceeded with framing of charge, full stop. The said order came to be affirmed by the High Court on dismissal of the writ petition preferred by the unsuccessful appellant, while its impugned judgment dated 22nd November 2018, full stop para. Ms. Kamini Jaiswal, Learned Counsel for the Appellant, submits that the impugned judgment has resulted in grave miscarriage of justice and is based on an erroneous interpretation of the factual circumstances of the case, and the High Court has not taken into consideration the oral and documentary evidence on record in the proper perspective, which has vitiated the entire proceedings and led to gross injustice.